Steve Austin interfered in not one title match, costing the Road Dogg a chance at the Hardcore Championship, but a second title match by stunning both X-Pac and Al Snow in a European title match. Then he walks up to me as I try to find out what the hell is going on, and he's disrespectful.
You got dissed, face it. No respect. You're Rodney Dangerfield.
So now what I'd like to do is give Steve Austin a chance to come out here and explain his actions.
Is this his or else?
And I'm hoping, like most of you are, that we can come out of this with a very happy ending. So without further ado, Stone Cold, why don't you come on out here?
Why don't you say or else again?
And here comes the rattlesnake. And Austin, without a smile on his face, Austin obsessed in finding out who ran him down before the Survivor Series last November. And unfortunately, a lot of innocent people have been stunned and hammered in Austin's court of law. Well, I don't think Stone Cold Steve Austin has any confidence whatsoever in Mick Foley's Barney Fife investigation. Mick Foley's not going to be able to find the culprits that ran over Stone Cold, and Austin knows it. In the rattlesnake's court, you are guilty until proven innocent. But I certainly feel badly for the lack of respect that the rattlesnake has shown Mick Foley, who quite frankly deserves everyone's respect.
Well, if Mick Foley was smart, he would have hired F. Lee Bailey and Johnny Cochran and Marshall Clark. All of those people to get on the case here.
Steve, I understand that you have yourself a little problem with authority figures, but hell, I'm just the commissioner. I'm not necessarily your enemy. I am not Vince McMahon. I am very aware of your feelings about Vince McMahon. Hell, the Vince McMahon-Austin feud helped make the WWF what it is today. But look at me, Steve. I don't have Vince McMahon's money. I don't have Vince's suits. I damn sure don't have his hairstyle. I don't even have Vince McMahon's guns. But you got to understand this. As commissioner, when I make a promise, I need to keep it, or else I might as well not even be in the damn ring. Now, I understand you got run over by an automobile. I understand you're a little bit pissed off. You are free to conduct your investigation any way you see fit. But I need to have your word on this matter, and that word is you will not interfere in matches again.
Sounds like the commissioner is up. Position ultimatum. Yeah.
You see, that's where we got the biggest problem of the night, right here. You keep saying that you're trying to help me. You make all these promises. Oh, you're going to help Stone Cold out with the investigation. You're going to get to the bottom of it. Hold back, Stone Cold. Don't stun anybody. You ain't proved a damn thing, but sit on your ass to me.
Man. Yeah. True.
And let me just go on record as saying how lackadaisical and how laughable your actions have been as far as trying to help Stone Cold. Over the weekend, I was sitting at the house in front of a pile of empty beer cans.
I believe that.
And a commercial came on the TV, and it got me to thinking. I said, yeah, maybe I need to go outside to get some help. So it might not have been a very good decision at the time, but I picked up the phone. I know, yeah, I called Cleo on the psychic hotline.
Oh, Cleo. The psychic hotline.
You know Cleo.
Yeah.
After about 2.5 beers of listening to Cleo, I realized, one, she had a pretty cool accent, but two, Cleo didn't have a clue who ran over Stone Cold Steve Austin. And I can look in your eyes and listen to your voice and tell that you ain't got a clue either. Meanwhile, the son of a bitch that ran Stone Cold over is in the back somewhere, and you ain't doing a damn thing about it.
You see, right. That's where you're wrong, Steve. Uh-oh. That's where you're wrong. I understand. Maybe my actions have seemed a little bit lackadaisical to you. So what I did at my own expense is I brought in a suspect who at the time was not just a suspect, but a prime suspect. And I flew that damn person in with my own money. He's here tonight, and he will come out to face the music. So Badass Billy Gunn,
what?
Come on out.
Badass Billy Gunn.
Say first off, welcome back to the WWF. But more importantly, Foley has single-handedly solved the case. So Stone Cold, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let you two gentlemen be alone, and I'm gonna let you handle and make the verdict Stone Cold style. Thank you very much.
So Foley thinks he settled the case?
What does that mean, Stone Cold style?
I think we both probably know what that means, but
also, that taking his eyes off Mr. Ass. Man, with this, talk about opening a can of whip ass.
Look at that. He could be the judge, the jury, and the executioner.
Austin's about to pull a plug or flip the switch.
Now, Stone Cold Steve Austin, I've been saying this for months, and I came here face to face, man to man. It's true, the night that you got ran down, I could not be accounted for.
Uh-oh.
And yes, it's true, at the time I was a loyal member of DX.
Uh-oh.
And yes, and when you put two and two together, I am suspect number one.
Uh-oh.
But Stone Cold Steve Austin, I did not run you down.
He was late arriving at the building, was Mr. Ass, on that fateful night.
Yeah, but wait, you heard that, didn't you?
My flight was delayed in Detroit, and that might seem a little fishy, but hell, anyone could check on that. Hell, every cop that's on the case has checked on it.
It's been on United.
But I do have some information for you.
Oh,
here we go.
That's good.
Evidence.
Yeah.
When we drove into the Joe Louis Arena, a car came hauling ass by me. And when I looked back at the footage, it was the same car that ran you down. And for that split second, I saw the driver, and that's information that you want.
Oh, man, this is it.
Who was it?
Mr. Ass knows.
You see, whoever the driver was, he or she had blonde hair.
Wait a minute. So does Mr. Ass.
Now, I'm not just saying this to tell you what you want to hear. Hell, you can ask the Brooklyn Brawler. He's the one that picked me up at the airport. And I'm not telling you this just to save DX's ass. Don't get me started on that.
Oh boy.
I'm telling you this, Stone Cold, because it's the truth.
Man, you believe it?
Now, that storm bring a tear to a glass eye, son. But I can sit here and I can look in your eyes, and I can listen to the sound of your voice. And I believe what you're saying is true.
He believes him. Stone Cold believes Mr. Ass.
But the bottom line is, I never really liked you much anyway.
As another innocent man falling victim to the Stone Cold Stunner. This is not what Mick Foley